Today we are going to discuss what are rate limits, why do we have rate limits on the APIs, and then we will go through the rate limits for the OpenAI API. So rate limits are the restrictions that a system imposes on how many times a user can access the system within a specified period of time. Suppose I have a system which can handle 100 requests in 1 minute and I have 10 users. So I'll set the API rate limit to 10 requests per minute for each user. Otherwise, one user can send 100 requests and the system will be blocked for that one user. So instead of the system working dedicatedly just for that one user, we will set the rate limits of 10 requests per minute for each user. And that way, in each minute, all those 10 users can utilize their 10 requests per minute and they can get benefit of the system within their specified period of time. Rate limits also help protect against the misuse or abuse of the system. So there may be users sending aggressively millions of requests to the system and the system can be unexpectedly shut down or restarts, or the resource consumption could go beyond the attached resources and it can put like unbearable load on the system infrastructure. Rate limits help ensure that everyone has fair access to the system. Rate limits can help manage the aggregate load on the infrastructure. Now, what are some rate limits on the OpenAI API? OpenAI API has put the rate limits in 5 different ways. Those 5 different ways are request per minute, token per minute, then request per day, then token per day, and also images per minute. On the OpenAI side, they have set the limits based on organizations, and then under the organization, you will have different projects. So you can set limits on each project, and you will also have the limits on your organizational level. Let's go into the details of all these limits from the OpenAI API and see what limits we have from the OpenAI API. So when you sign up on the OpenAI platform as a user, you have that user entity, and then under the users you have an organization. And when you sign up to the OpenAI platform, you get a default organization, and that organization has the rate limits, which is called the organizational limits. Organizational limits are incremental and they are tier based. So initially you will be in tier 1 and you will have a different set of limits on your organization for the API access, and then when you have enough spending you will move to the tier 2 and your organizational limits for the API request will increase accordingly. So the same way as you are spending more, you are moving to the next tier, and that way your organizational limits are increasing accordingly. So here I am in the OpenAI documentation and you can see the different tiers for the organization. So these are the usage tiers for the organization. So initially you are in the free tier, and if you pay $5 you move to the tier 1, and when you pay $50 you move to the tier 2. So based on each of these tier you get different set of limits for the API request, which we are going to discuss in detail a bit later. So under the organization you can have different projects. So initially when you have a default organization, you will have also a default projects, and all the API requests you are sending to the OpenAI that will goes under the default project and the default organization. But if you want to have another project, maybe for another team or another group of people, you can create multiple projects, and each project will have its own set of members, and each set can have its own limits for the number of requests and for the number of tokens. So by default, when you create a project, the rate limits are inherited from the organizational limits. So if you don't set the limits for a project, by default it will use the organizational limits. And if you need more control on the set of limits and also the set of members for each group, then you can create separate projects for each group of people or for each team. So maybe you have a sales team, you have a development team, you have a marketing team, and all of them are using the OpenAI API based on their needs. So using the projects, you can create one project for each team. You can set your limits and users to that project, and also each project has its own API key as well. This way you can control the access by using a different API key and using a different set of API request limits. And one other thing is that using different set of projects,
you can even monitor the usage of which team has spent how much money and how many requests they have sent to the API. If you have different teams in your organizations, this structure will exactly map to whatever team structure you have. So you will have one organization, and in the organizations you have different teams. So for each team you create a different project, and then you can monitor the rate limits, you can set the rate limits, you can send the spending, and then you can monitor the usage for each project independently. So now I'll move to the OpenAI dashboard, and I'll walk you through the organization limits, the project limits, and how we can manage all these things in the OpenAI dashboard. So here I am in the OpenAI dashboard, and you can see here this is the organizations I have. So currently I have just this one organization, and then under the organization I have these different projects. So initially I had a default project, and then later I created another project called OpenAI Essentials. And if you want to create other projects, you can create it from under the projects tab here by going to the create project. And to see the limits for the organization and for the project, you will go to the settings, and then under the settings I have this organization, and then I have this project settings. So under the organizations I have organization name, ID, and if I go to the members, you will see all the members you have added to your organizations. And then you can go to the limits, and you can see under the limits that the usage is tier 1. So currently I am in the tier 1, and these limits are showing based on the tier 1 limits. So for the GPT-4o model, I have a token limit of 30,000 tokens per minute, and in terms of request, I can send 500 requests per minute. If I am sending requests in the form of batch, the limits increase to 90,000 tokens per minute. So this way each model has a different set of limits in terms of tokens and in terms of request under the tier 1. And here you can set the limits for your organization. So I can set a monthly budget here. So whatever budget you have for the API usage for the whole month, you can set it here. Here it's mentioned that if your organization exceeds this budget in the given calendar month, subsequent API request will be rejected. So instead of monitoring manually the monthly usage limit for the OpenAI API, you can set the limit here, and it will automatically block the requests after you have reached that limit. You can also set a notification threshold. The limits may be reached to the 80% usage or 90% usage. You will be notified through an email, and then you can take the actions accordingly. So here if you want to increase the limits, as I mentioned that these limits are coming from the OpenAI platform, and you cannot increase the organization limits yourself. If you want to increase the limits for your organization, you need to spend whatever criteria is for that tier, and then when you are moved to that tier, your limits will be automatically increased. It's mentioned here that your organization is currently in usage tier 1. Your limits will be automatically increased once you move to the next usage tier. And here my current tier is tier 1. Once the following criteria are met, you will be automatically moved to the next tier. So once I spend $50 on the OpenAI API, there are at least 7 days passed after the successful payment, I'll be moved to the tier 2. And then once I move to tier 2, I'll have these limits increased to a different set of numbers. So these are the organization limits, and these are coming as a default. So now if you want to have another team, maybe 2 or 3 teams, and each team will have a different set of limits under these limits, so you can go to the projects. So here I am in the project. I can see the project members here. So currently I don't have any member in this team, and if I go to the limits, I can set the monthly budget, as we have set a monthly budget here for the organization, and an email threshold. You can set the monthly budget for each project, and you can also set a notification threshold also. So I have set monthly budget to $1, but if you want to, you can go to edit here and you can set it to $2. And now this project will not exceed the monthly spending beyond $2. In the same way, you can set a notification threshold. And then we go to the rate limits, and here you can see that for the GPT 3.5 Turbo, I have set this limit of 20 tokens per minute and 2 requests per minute. This is the organizational limits, which is 200k tokens per minute, and this is the project limit. I cannot increase this project limit beyond this 200k, so this is the maximum limit because it's coming from the organization, and within a project you cannot exceed the organization limits. So same goes for the request here. The request limits for the organization is 500 requests per minute, and I have set it to 2 for this project. Anyone using this OpenAI essential project, and if they are using the OpenAI API key for this specific projects, these are the limits which the user needs to follow. If the user is using GPT 3.5 Turbo, the limits will be set to this. And if the user is using GPT 4.0 Mini, the limits will be set to this. If I go to the edit, I can see all the models here. And for each model, you have this edit button or input box, and you can set your limits under your organization limits. So if I try to go above the organization limits, it will not allow me to do that. So you can see it automatically set back to 20 because I tried to increase the limit above the organization limits. So suppose I want to set the tokens to 10 tokens per minute. The request per minute, I'll set it to 3 and then I'll save it. Now I have 10 tokens per minute for GPT 3.5 Turbo. This way you can set the limits for each project and for each model. And if you want to add another project, you can go to this tab here. From here, you can create another project, and I'll call it, for example, sales. And now you can see that I am under the sales project, and it is created with the default organization limits. So I don't have any setting for spending or for limits, but if you want to, you can set budget and set alerts for the sales project. And if I switch back to the OpenAI essential project, I can see these different set of limits for spending and also for the requests. I hope you have got the idea of rate limits for the OpenAI API. So I'll just quickly revise it. So first you have a user when you sign up, and when you sign up as a user, you get a default organization. That default organization comes in with the default set of limits called organization limits, and that organization will have a limit of spending, a limit of request per minute, and also a limit of request per day, tokens per minute, tokens per day, and all those are coming from the OpenAI platform. As your usage increase and you move to the next tier, your organization limits will be increases accordingly. If you want to set different API limits for your different teams, you can create different projects for each team, and then you can add your team members to each relevant project, and you can set your monthly budget and also your rate limits for each project accordingly. So in the next video, we are going to discuss how we can send a batch of requests to the OpenAI API. So if you want to generate more data and you need to send multiple requests at the same time, how you can batch all those requests into just one request and then submit it to the OpenAI API, and then you can monitor that batch of requests, and once it is completed, you can start getting the response. So using the OpenAI batch API, we will try to send asynchronous requests to the OpenAI API. So see you in the next video.